Welcome to Straight Talk for Women Only. I'm Judy.
I'm Janelle.
And I'm Mary.
And we're so happy to be back with you.
Yay.
We took a couple of months of a little break, but we are back and we are hot tonight.
Yes, we are.
We're ready.
We're
yes, we are. We are ready. We are going to talk about tonight, how would you rate your friendships with other women?
Good topic.
This is a good topic because one thing that I've heard people say, you know, women can be catty or women can be gossipy or...
I hear a lot of women say, I don't have women friends, I just have men friends.
I've heard that a lot.
That is just ridiculous.
Ridiculous is not the word.
Yeah, well, they don't realize what the enemy's stealing from them when they act like that and do like that because...
So we want to shoot down that philosophy tonight.
Absolutely.
Totally, because what we've discovered through our lifetime
Absolutely.
Is that women friends are very important.
They are.
Super important. Mm-hmm. And the benefit of having women friends,
Amen.
Good
mm-hmm.
friends, mm-hmm. Friends that you can trust, friends
Amen.
That you're comfortable with.
Yes.
You know, there's just so much in having a friend
you can
that
just
are women.
Be yourself with.
Right.
You don't have to be anything. Put on a mask. You don't have to alter what you say or
right.
how you say. It's just
they're not
going to
judge you.
No.
Exactly.
You are who you are. They love you right where you're at.
Yes.
You know, and they just there to stand with you, encourage you, bleed with you, cry with you, pray with you, whatever mm-hmm. the situation calls for. Mm-hmm. They're there because mm-hmm. they love you.
Yeah. I want to address the women being catty and mm-hmm. gossipy. Well, it's usually other women that are saying that, right?
Right.
And so when women say, I don't have women friends,
right.
I only have male. To
right.
me, I think that is a form of self-hatred because how could you not get along with what you are?
Amen.
You know what I mean?
That's good.
You
right?
are
That's
a woman.
Very good.
So it's almost like, well, the things that you don't like about other women or you perceive about other women, are you carrying them yourself? Is it
right.
really your own everything
issues.
In you, right, that you're trying to reflect on other women? Because if you're healthy as a woman, if you're whole as a woman, then you should be able to get along with other women.
Right,
doesn't
exactly.
mean they're all going to be your best friend,
right.
but you should be able to get along. I can say, Judy, them pink glasses look good on
all
you.
All right, yeah.
And I can
girl.
Say, thank you, Janine. I like them myself.
Well, when we talk about the three different types of...
relationships.
Yes.
That fits right
okay,
in
here are the
said.
Three different types of relationships. And you can avoid heartache by putting people in your life in the right category.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
There's the confidant, mm-hmm. which is the close friend or associate to whom secrets are confided or with whom private matters and problems are discussed. Someone you can be transparent and honest with.
Right.
So that's usually what you would call your BFF.
Your best, yeah. right.
Your
BBF, right.
Bestie.
Your best friend, your ace king, goom, boom,
yes.
boom, whatever.
Now, let me ask the two of you, because I just want to know this. How many BFFs mm-hmm. are just really that kind of a friend mm-hmm. that you discuss private matters, you're transparent, honest mm-hmm. with? How many of those do you say you have in your life?
Two.
Say three.
Three.
And one's long distance.
Yeah, I would say two.
Two?
Mm-hmm. How about you?
I would say...
She doesn't have any friends.
I have to think about... I have to think about how many I have. No, I would say two.
Two. Mm-hmm.
Because there's some people that you could be with and you have a good time with them, but you mince your words.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You guard your words, guard what you say.
Mm-hmm.
You're not totally just
right.
your total self with all
yeah.
right.
guards dropped down, all mask off.
So you kind of pick and choose the time you spend with that person.
Yeah.
Because that's
right.
work.
Oh, yeah.
It
that's
is.
That's work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then there's a friend that you can just
say anything to. And not be afraid
right.
of
judge, or they're gonna tell somebody else, or they're gonna you know, try to belittle you. They're just gonna hear what you have to say, and then help you, encourage you, because
mm-hmm.
you should have someone who's gonna sow into your life,
right.
you know, to be a blessing to you, not to be a hindrance or be
and build you up.
And build you and lift you. Yeah, sure.
But you know. Somebody that can be totally honest with you,
at the same time, right. The wounds
and
of a friend.
You can receive it from them.
Talks about it in the Word, right? The wounds of a friend is better than the, what is it, Proverbs, it talks about
I
that.
Does it say the faithful wounds of a friend?
Something,
or
it has something to heal.
Look it up and
look
call
it up
us so to tell us what.
Somebody text us that, or where's the phone? Yeah, text us that on the wounds of a friend is better than the
questions at stfwo.com.
But yeah, you to have a good BBF, best BFF. What's that? BFF, whatever
BFF.
They call it.
Mm-hmm. Best friends
sounds
forever.
Like something else to me. But anyway, but yeah, best friends forever.
Would you say that your friendships have changed as you've gotten older?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think you have, to the point that you said before, there's some people that you have a good time with, but you have to watch your words. I think we have to know where people fit in our lives. So we don't make the mistake of thinking, oh, this person is a BFF, and they're really not.
Right.
They're just somebody you like to go to the movies with, because they are always the life of the party, they always have a good time, and you enjoy being with
you
them.
Laugh
exactly,
a lot.
Exactly, but you wouldn't.
They may think
problem.
That was a BFF.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's true.
They may think it, but then you may have a total different, you know, thought about it.
Yeah, it's important where people fit. You know?
Yeah. So what's the other one? What is it?
Okay. Constituents. Mm-hmm. They are with you for a cause, not for you. They will confuse you because they appear to be a confidant, but their attraction is the mission.
Yeah, and you got to be careful, especially if you're in ministry.
Yes.
Exactly.
Talk about it, Mary.
Because when you're in ministry,
yeah.
you might have a lot of people gather to
right.
you,
mm-hmm.
but are they really your friends?
Friends, right.
Or are they someone just with you for the cause?
Yeah,
they like the way
the
you
cause,
preach. They like the way you
they're
minister. They like
you.
To glean from
yeah.
you. They like to pull from you.
They're after something.
Yeah, they're after something
yeah.
that you
so you
have
to be very, because the enemy will do that. He'll use people, you know, just to get close to you to try to, you know, get all your business and then go spread it out.
Exactly.
Because you may be thinking that you're friends with that person and you spill out your heart about something and then they just take it because they don't really consider you as a friend.
Right.
They're just after something.
Yep.
And I think the Holy Spirit will show you people like that.
Believe me, he
shows you. I've had the Lord speak to me before and just say, they're a snake in the grass.
Yeah, yeah. He
and then
shows
I knew,
you.
Okay, am I still going to be friendly to them? Oh, yes. Am I still going to talk to them? Oh, yes. But you watch what you say.
Right.
And they're not a confidant.
Right. They're not a confidant.
That you can share your problems with.
See, with me, when they do like that with me, I give them so much word. They ain't gonna run from me.
they're
gonna be pulled in. And they're gonna get set free in the name of Jesus. But yeah, because I do. I really try to discern, and I do pray very well in that area, regards to you know who's around me, who, you know, and you have to deal with them in the respect of ministry, like you were saying. You know, you can't just say anything and communicate anything
exactly
to
because
them.
Some people can't handle that.
Well, even Jesus had the 3. The 12 and the 70, and they all have different missions, you know, that he had. The 3 was the inner circle. Then there's the 12, you know, disciples. And then, of course, the 70 he sent out for works of the ministry.
Wow. So that's kind of like his confidants, his constituents.
Yeah.
And then what's the third one?
Comrades.
Yeah.
A person who shares in one's activities, occupation, etc. A fellow member of a fraternal group or a political party, they join with you to help what you are against. Mm-hmm. Such as if you're standing against abortion
or anything. Could be the right to vote, whatever your cause is, whatever you're for. And also that co-workers can fall into that.
Right.
That's right.
Co-workers.
Yeah. Because you guys are kind of on the same team, but it's really just for that occupation.
And that occupation.
Right, and once you leave, that's it.
It's
you know, church is like that a lot, too, because there are people that you spend time with in church.
Oh, in church, right, you fellowship.
Right, you fellowship with them in church, and if you're like us and you go to church a lot, you see people a lot and you spend time with them a lot, but they're still not
your BFF.
Yeah, they're not friends.
They're not friends.
They're not friends, right.
You know, but you can get that twisted. That happened to me, and the Holy Spirit had to speak to me and say, when you leave here, leave them here.
Right.
And I said, okay.
Wow.
And it helped me not get offended, It helped me not, you know, be upset or point fingers or get my feelings hurt or anything like that. I was able to put it in perspective and put the relationships in perspective.
Because there's, even in the church, there's people that don't understand, well, all of us here, we're in the ministry. Mm-hmm. You know, we do the work of the ministry. Mm-hmm. And there's times that people don't understand that you're just a regular person. Mm-hmm. Like someone said to me the other day, I was in Walmart. No, I was at the mall. Mm-hmm. And I saw a couple from the church, and they came up to me, and they're like, Pastor Judy, you go to the mall?
Yeah.
No, I shop on the streets of gold.
My clothes just come down.
Yeah, and that really surprised me because I thought, wow, there are
people
out there that just...
You'd be surprised how people think totally...
Well, they only see you in one setting, probably.
That's true.
Only time they see you is at church. So if you're any place else, it's like... The grocery store, you eat?
You shop?
No. You shop? Yeah.
Where's your mate at?
You don't get manna? Manna doesn't fall from heaven?
Exactly.
Oh, that's amazing.
Now, one thing that I've discovered, honestly, I didn't realize this until I started doing a little research about friendships, is that when we're with our friends, satisfying friendship predict longevity, protect against obesity, depression, and heart disease.
That's what kind of friendship?
Satisfying friendship.
Satisfying.
If you have good friendships.
Yeah. Because it says in this, what I have here, what does it take to be a friend? And it says, communication is the lifeblood of a relationship. As long as we communicate open and honestly, our friendship will grow and mature. And when you share who you are, your emotions, you begin to discover yourself, what your value, your esteem, and your desire. So that's basically confirming what you just said, because who we're emotional women are more, you know, so it's all right to have emotions, but we don't want them to be all over the place. So we have a good friend, a BFF, and y'all can talk about things, you can laugh about things, you can have fun, you can fall out laughing.
So things you get to just, release
stuff. Yeah, you release,
of
it's, yeah.
Eating,
holding it in.
Instead
right.
of holding in, and it's
exactly.
affecting your heart, negative emotions
right.
affecting
right.
your heart.
Sometimes you just want to share something that's hurting you. And somebody, you know, I've had that happen, I had to speak on certain things, and the person would just talk into my life, and all of a sudden I felt, you know, like, thank God. You know,
so
it makes a difference.
Just talking.
You do. Just talking it out. You know, just sharing it. You can't keep things in. That's where the enemy torments you. So, but if you have somebody that you can trust, that is a good friend, you know, that you can just call up any time, day or night, and they ain't gonna judge you. You know, you have something, you need something, and it's no problem. They ain't judging. Well, girl, again, what's wrong with you? Blah blah blah. No, it's just.
Or they see your number ringing on their phone.
Yes, oh
like,
Lord,
quit.
Here she.
You know, I can't deal with this.
Oh
right
Lord, here
this,
she.
You know.
But it's really having that unconditional love for your friend and to be able to, go ahead.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think that we attract?
Who we are and what we are?
Yes.
Yes.
So could our friends be a reflection of what's going on with us or the type of people we are?
Sometimes, and sometimes yes, and sometimes it could be an assignment.
Okay.
I believe that sometimes God sends people into your life. I have a thing that I always say, and if that's the case, you got to, we as Christians, we are who we are, and if God sends somebody for us to pour into their lives, to build them up, to stand with them, to pray with them, maybe they're going through something and they need what you have, and so therefore they may come for a season or a reason, and they may come for whatever the purpose. So, but again, is you have to discern, you know, who they are in your measure of friendship.
Right.
So therefore, I always have this saying. Either I'm gonna pull you, or you're gonna pull me, and I ain't going back. So you're gonna either run to the light, or you're gonna run from the light. But if it's a person, and I've had this happen a number of times, where they don't even know why they keep being drawn. We have nothing in common a lot of times, but it's the Holy Spirit.
Right.
And that's how you have to really be discerning. Is God really assigning this person to be in your life or around you for a specific reason, time, or a season? And I've had that happen, and
I've had that happen too.
I'm sure, you know.
Where, it's always and I thought they were such a good friend to me that I thought, well, we'd be together forever. I love this person, love seeing them, but we don't talk every day like we used to.
Right.
It was for
a reason and a season.
It was an assignment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and you have to make sure you know the difference. You don't run everybody off from you just because of, oh, they, I don't, you know, because see, now that we are in the kingdom, everything is in what God has purpose and plan for us. So we, even in friendships, my friendships have changed versus when years ago up to now, like we already said. You know, because we think different, we act different, we are different. We we are totally, behold, we all become new. So it's who, sometimes you may even find yourself really moving forward in a season of time that you go, where are my friends? What happened? Where'd they go?
But you feel like you're all alone.
Right. But God is working something in and working something out to bring you. I remember one time when James and I first got married, he said his family, who was his friends, I said, oh, and I said, well, my friends are my family. So there's friends that are like family to me, and then there's friends that are just, you know, hi and goodbye, see you later, let's go to the movie, or we may meet every once a year for our birthdays, you know, that type of associates, we might call associates, them that. But yeah, as Christians, we really have to be monitoring who does come into our life, whether they're for a reason, or they're for a season, or they're for purpose, or they're for us to pour into them, or maybe God has them to pour into you.
Right. You know, it took me a minute to get that, being a Christian, because my girlfriend, who is one of my best friends, would have people in her life, and then she would say, well, you know, God said it was that season was over and it was time for it. And I'm thinking,
what kind of friend are you?
I'm like, Christians are flaky. You know, like, how are you going to have a friend and then say, okay, it's time for us not to be friends anymore. God said I can't be your friend. But I got it.
Yeah.
I got it. It's just, sometimes it is like that, like what you just said. People are there for a season.
Reason or season.
Season or reason.
Right.
And when either one of them are up, it's time to move on. And it can be done gracefully.
Absolutely.
It doesn't have to be done abruptly.
Exactly.
I'm glad you said that, because if you look back at all the friends that you had, you call your best friends, close friends, confidants, or can you still pick up a phone? Can you still get in contact with them? Can you say, hey, how's, and is you're still tight or good with that person?
Yeah.
You know, not, you're not hanging around, you're not no longer, you know,
we don't mind with each other every day like we used to be.
But you can still say, hey, girl, just thinking about you today. I was going on my phone, but how you doing? Oh, girl, I'm doing fine, blah, blah, blah. It's like you never left.
Yeah, exactly.
You never disconnected. Mm-hmm.
But they're not daily involved in your daily life.
Exactly.
You know, you have to catch up.
And that's how you want to leave a friendship is what you're basically saying.
Right, exactly.
That's
where you can always
go
back and say hi, as opposed to leaving them bruised or wounded.
Right.
You know, just
exactly.
With the departure.
And when it's got it, it kind of works its way out. It does, you know.
Now let me ask you another question. Do you think that you or God will send friends in your life, or you have friends that match to where you are in your life right now? Like if you're really busy, really busy, it's hard to have a friend that's really needy. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Like you have things, you got stuff to do.
Place to go, just, people to see.
Right, and they're kind of like, you didn't call me today.
Oh,
you
Lord.
You didn't do this today. You didn't. That, do you think that God would match you? Like, how important is it
to
have
pulling on you, like, in other words?
Are where you are.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
I think it's important, and I think it just, it kind of just happens.
Right, okay.
You know, like, I have a, I still call her my friend, but we're not like we used to be because my life changed really drastically and so did hers. Sometimes do I want that back? Yeah. Sometimes I kind of long for a little bit of that back. But then I understand we're both in totally different places right now. You know, and we may just connect on a birthday or connect on Facebook with different things going on in each of our lives. But what we used to have is just, it's not, it's just not there because we're both at totally different places.
Well, I guess an answer to what you were saying, would God put a needy person into your life? I think he would, for not necessarily being your best friend,
right?
But to help them because you may have what they need. And
is that person your best friend?
No, that's what I just said. No. That's what I just told her. I said that it's not necessarily
not your best friend,
but it's somebody that God. So you have to make that distinction.
God's planted there, placed
now,
there.
Now, if they start making, thinking that you are my BFF, mm-hmm. because you're paying attention, you're ministering to them, you're talking to them, mm-hmm. you're taking your time with them, because God is moving on your heart to do that, mm-hmm. pour into their lives, then you eventually have to make that, you know, distinction, mm-hmm. you know, because they can get so, I'm telling you, people can get so attached to you mm-hmm. that they'll be jealous of your other friendships.
That's true. Yes.
I've seen that happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I had to fight that
off.
That's
a scary thing.
Yeah, that is, and I've seen it happen.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to ask that because I know there's somebody out there that might be dealing with that situation. Mm-hmm. You know,
sure.
You have a friend that's needy, and you might be looking at the phone saying, you know what I mean?
That's what the problem is now.
So, oh, Lord, help me, Jesus. But you know what? Sometimes and that can and that will happen. Mm-hmm. But it's like I said, okay, Lord, you got to help me. Mm-hmm. Give me what I need to say now, you know, because sometimes your flesh. I mean, we're still in this earthen vessel, you know, but you don't know when that person's really going to need what you have to say.
Right, right. So you may be being willing to give and knowing your place in their lives.
Right, knowing your place in their lives. Mm-hmm. They may not know their place, but you know.
Right.
And then you can control the situation mm-hmm. inappropriately mm-hmm. so that it doesn't get out of order mm-hmm. and it mm-hmm. stays in order.
Yep. I want to read this. Were you going to say something?
No.
Okay. I want to read this.
I'm at your disposal. Whatever you want to say.
scripture based on the importance of friendship. We are not designed to be alone. I like that because we're not.
Mm. Right.
Genesis 2:18. It is not good for man to be alone. Alone means solo. One, not having companionship. So that doesn't mean just a husband and a wife.
Huh?
It means this alone meaning solo, because we're
alone.
Created interdependently.
No, we're created to have friends.
And I
Absolutely.
Said that this scripture is usually
we always use it for husband and wife.
Yes. Right, usually yeah. used
that's,
for that.
Yeah, that's probably why them women say, I don't need no women friends. I got my man. I got my men friends and something mm-hmm. like that. So then they find out.
We are all looking for somebody to love, both romantically and as intimate friends. Now I have another question. I'm full of questions.
I know
tonight.
You are.
Is it important? Now I know we're talking about women friendship, female friendships, mm-hmm. but I want to ask this question. Is it important that you are a friend with your spouse?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, you better be. Whew.
Absolutely. You should be friends first okay. before you're anything else.
Absolutely.
Okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. Do you agree?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
The way you did your glasses.
Because I'm saying,
sure.
Yeah, be friends first. Mm-hmm. Okay. We need to share the difference between deep love and respect and high and by relationships. What is that? An intimate friend?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
It's
confident.
That confidant, mm-hmm. the one you can
confident.
Be transparent, honest, share
Open.
Private matters and problems.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is a quote by McGinnis in The Friendship Factor. In research at our clinic, my colleagues and I have discovered that friendship is the springboard to every other love. Mm. That's a good quote.
Yeah.
It is. Mm-hmm. I believe that.
To every other love. Because it teaches you how to trust, to communicate, to encourage, to love unconditionally, because mm-hmm. even when you have friends, they still get on your nerves. Mm-hmm. But you don't dump them and say, that's it, that's all of them, I'm
exactly.
sick of this.
Right, right.
But this thing here says, when conflict comes, we have three options. We can strike out, walk out, or talk it out.
Mm. Right.
And sometimes people walk out on a perfectly great relationship.
Yeah.
And because they got in a little squirmish, mm-hmm. somebody's mm-hmm. feelings got hurt or offended. Mm-hmm. And then the enemy worked them over. And they just said, you know what, I can't be bothered her no more. I'm sick of her, she thinks she isn't. And they just walked out.
And lost a friendship.
Lost a good friendship.
Yeah. Yeah.
The very one that God wanted to multiply and increase life in your life mm-hmm. by what they are to you. Mm-hmm. You know.
Which I think your friendships have to be, those confidant friendships have to be so important to you that, where's my little stuff I wrote down about that? Okay, you have to invest in your friend, respect your friend. Mm-hmm. Respect is very important.
Yes. Yes.
If you have a friend that's constantly putting you down,
hit the road, Jet.
Cussing at you.
Whoa.
You tell them something and they make fun of it, or they'll say, "Well, I was just kidding you."
But they ain't kidding.
No, that's not the kind of friend we're talking about here because that's not really a confidant.
Right.
And those are toxic relationships.
Yes. Yes. And respect means value. You put value on what they're saying,
how they feel,
and all of that.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yes. And you value them as a person. Yeah. Treasure your friend. Keep your friends' confidences. That's very important to me.
It is.
Very important.
If I have someone that I know talks, I don't share things with them because I don't want my business all out there like I hear them talking about other people's business.
Yeah, if they're talking about other folk, they're talking about you.
They're talking about you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's
true.
Sacrifice and commitment. It says learn to sacrifice your schedule, time, activities, and perhaps even your activities and you. It says even your belongings for the sake of a relationship. Mm. Learn to sacrifice your schedule, your time, activities, and perhaps even your belongings for the sake of a relationship.
Being given.
A true friend is characterized by mutual loyalty and interdependence, not codependence. Right. That's what we were kind of alluding to, that needy. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes that's a needy person. They want to
be dependent on you. Mm-hmm. Do this and do that and be with them and talk to them, take time with them. You're their world, and mm-hmm. your friends like
you. Yeah, that's not healthy.
That's not healthy at all.
That's not healthy.
And Proverbs 17:17, a friend loves at all times, good, bad, ugly, whatever. Stay committed.
Yeah, that's kind of like the litmus test for friendship. Mm-hmm. You know, wherever you are in your life, is that person going, are they there with you?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Are they going, when you're down in the dumps, mm-hmm. are they walking away from you or are they there with you?
Well, that's don't you always hear that saying when the person goes through some drama, trauma, something really, and they say, you know what? I know who my real friends are.
Yeah.
You hear it all the time.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Now I know, because you're surprising who steps up to the plate mm-hmm. when you need somebody, you know, in a time of need. And the ones that you expect, mm-hmm. a lot of times they're not there.
Exactly. And that's what weeds out
the friendship
from the people that are just a constituent or just mm-hmm. an associate.
Right. Or just using you.
Because if they're not there,
the heart's not really
there
for you.
Then they're just with you for whatever they can glean, whatever they can get from
you.
Mm-hmm.
Right. It's not about you. They love you for who you are, mm-hmm. and just have love for you, mm-hmm. unconditional love.
Now you had something on your card about acceptance on one of those cards. Did we read that one?
Acceptance. Trust and trustworthiness.
I want to say something about where it said that you have to make time for your friend mm-hmm. to cultivate that relationship, and how friendships are work. Mm. And I know.
You know, I love that word.
That word work. Yeah.
Because she got 50 million kids and she don't have the time for her friends.
Uh-oh. Well, that's what I want to talk
about. That's true. I know. I already know.
Because it's important to make that time.
It's mm-hmm. important to make that statement, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so important to do that because we do get very busy.
Mm-hmm.
For me to make time to go out to a movie with a friend, there's so much I have to juggle to make it happen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I have to find out, how can I cultivate this relationship because it's very important to me. Mm-hmm. How can I make time to spend time with my friends? Mm-hmm. What can I do in my life to let some things go mm-hmm. so that I can cultivate this that's so important to me, and not just when I need that friend?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
See? Because there might be something.
Right.
But see, there might be some times that you just call them when you've got a great big problem, mm-hmm. and not just to fellowship.
Right. Well, number one, it's not the quantity of time, it's the quality of time
yes.
that you spend.
Yeah.
And number two, again, being a good friend, a BFF. Mm-hmm. BFF. Okay, mm-hmm. I'm going to start using that word. You're my BFF now. it's that friend would understand that.
That's what I was thinking.
Wow, yes. That's good.
They're not going to judge you.
A real friend would understand.
That is, see, that's so good.
Yeah, they know. Because, again, they know, they meet you where you are,
yes.
what you're going through, what you, and they're there for you when they need to be there, because they still always consider themselves a friend,
mm-hmm. a
BFF.
That's why, though, we
a
each
very good
said
friend.
We didn't go over three in our friendships,
right.
because, really,
you can't. Well, let me not say you can't, but...
But more than likely, you...
I always tell my kids, if you find they're all, you know, when they're going through mm-hmm. about this friend that didn't treat them right, or this friend did this, if you find one or two good friends in your life mm-hmm. that are really good friends, like this confidant friend, mm-hmm. you've done something.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Don't look for the multitudes. Just find one or two.
One or two is good enough.
You can't spend quality time with the multitude
right.
of people.
You can't.
You know, what do? If you have five BFFs, so what? That's
right.
five weekends in a row you
right.
go out
unless
with
Unless you
one
always
of them, and then,
do things together, mm-hmm. unless the, all five
right.
of you
are, then everyone would know each other.
Then you have something right. more like in a common, something, what do they call that? Say, for instance, if you have a sisterhood, mm-hmm. you all graduated high school.
Right.
Yes.
You get together
yeah.
once a year. Mm-hmm. Or I have people that I know that I still consider friends. They're not BFF.
Mm-hmm.
But I still know people that I worked with in corrections, and we'll get together maybe once or twice a year.
Right.
Or if different things I have with the DOE, the Doors of Vest, I can just call them and say mm-hmm. this or that, they're right there. Mm-hmm. They're still people, like associates, but they're friends.
Mm-hmm.
And there's one that is really, you know, she's almost like, I can't really call her my friend, but she's like a daughter to me.
Mm-hmm.
So again, you can have friends, but again, they take different, not
roles.
The measure, like we were talking about, they're not necessarily your best friend, but they're still your friends.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, people you can, every now and then say, hey girl, how you doing? I haven't heard you for a while. What you been up to?
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
a friend.
Mm-hmm.
Or then your BFF, the two friends or the mm-hmm. three friends, those are the ones you kind of have quality time.
Right.
You expand yourself a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
You have put in time and your heart and more so than mm-hmm. you would with just your associates.
Mm-hmm.
It's like we would call them friends. Mm-hmm. But they'll always be your friends because
mm-hmm.
there's no reason for them not to be your friends.
Right.
But just
friends
not
from
that
high school,
that maybe you're
friends
exactly.
from you where you worked at, mm-hmm. friends where you used to go to church at. Hey, I ain't seen you. Mm-hmm. She's a good friend of mine, but we're not necessarily BFF.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
Exactly.
So that's, you know, how you have to. And
to
basically we've been focusing on, I guess, the best friends, but you can have a lot of people, a lot of friends, but they just in different
categories.
Yeah.
Different categories.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
To double back with what you said about a friend would understand, and that's so important, because
yes.
a friend would understand. They would look at your life
mm-hmm.
or your life or my life and mm-hmm. see everything that is going on.
Right.
And
sure.
they know your heart.
Right.
So they know that you are not intentionally
right.
not trying to talk to them or not trying to call them or not
right.
trying to, you know, spend time with them, but you just, both hands are full right,
right.
now. You know, the plate is full.
So when you're together, you're together.
Right.
And when you're not, you're okay.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I was telling Pastor Judy earlier that I had a friend that would never call. I'd always be the one calling, hey girl, how you doing, blah, blah, blah. But she'd always be there on the spot if I ever needed anything, ever had anything, or, you know, times we, you know, I call her, we get to talking for hours or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you know, I'm sick of this. I'm the only what is wrong? I said, you know, my feelings started getting involved,
mm-hmm.
you know, because, you know, you're dealing with rejection.
Mm-hmm.
So the spirit was trying to manifest.
Right.
So I was like, you know what? Forget it. I ain't calling. In fact, I even kind of told her about it a little bit. She said, well, I just ain't the calling type. You know, I don't really call. And, well, you know, I'm like, all right. But I was at this ministry, and somebody was talking about friends.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, sometimes God will use you as the initiator,
mm-hmm.
and the other person may be not the one that's going to initiate it, or you may
mm-hmm.
be the one.
Mm-hmm.
I said, well, I guess I'm the one then.
Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes people don't know how to be a friend.
Yeah.
They don't know
that's
how.
True.
That is a good point, because I think what happens, that is so true, because if you befriend them, you befriend them, then they get a good example of what a good friend is. Mm-hmm. That's a good thing that you just said, because they don't know how. A lot of times, maybe they be dealing with rejection, or they think that women have hurt me in the past.
Right. Yeah.
I ain't going there no more. Yeah. They don't want to be hurt no more. Mm-hmm. So, you know, but if you get somebody who's consistent, constant, not
loyal.
Loyal. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. With and no the, hidden agenda.
Right. Mm-hmm.
The Bible has a lot to say about friendship. Mm-hmm. So we know it's important to God. A friend loves at all times.
Right, right.
There is a friend that sticks closer than any brother.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And it says to have friends, show yourself friendly.
Yes.
Right.
You want friends.
Right.
Yes,
show yourself friendly. Because a lot of times people won't do that and they wonder why they don't have no friends.
Right. And you're grumpy with the sour face
right.
all the time.
Because,
right.
see, you're getting no life in you.
Right.
See, conversation and communication comes from each other.
Yeah,
exactly.
I don't get along with women.
Yeah, then,
because your face.
And then a man don't even
want
to talk.
They don't want to talk.
And then
you get
a
BFF man, and he's just doing the listening because
right,
he ain't talking.
And he's trying to get in your under your skirt.
All right.
Mm-hmm. In your business.
Yeah, in your business. Mm-hmm. All right.
So I think we've established that friends are very important to us.
Yes.
That it's worth it in your busy life to cultivate your relationships, to have good friendships.
Yes.
And then maybe there's someone listening that you feel like I don't have any friends.
Right. That's true. A lot of people use the social media. That's their world.
Yeah, or just the texting, because you don't have to call the person, you don't have to hear the voice, it's quick, it's fast, you get your answers, and then you just go on your way.
Right.
And you can ignore them when you want to.
Yeah,
Isn't that
Sam, I'm so busy, or whatever your excuses are.
Don't respond,
yeah. Exactly. Mm-hmm. But if that's you, then pray and ask the Lord to give you friends.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, that you would like to have a good friend. Mm-hmm. Please, Lord. You know, bring people into my life, give me friends,
right.
and then show yourself friendly.
Yes.
Smile at people,
yes.
speak to people. The other thing is inquire about their life.
Right.
Yeah.
I've had some friends in my life that sometimes when I'm around them, I can't hardly breathe because it's like they're sucking the life out of me.
Yes.
Talk so much.
Oh, Lord.
And I can never get in a word edgewise, and so I just end up. I feel like
because you're probably
done,
the only one listening.
He's a puddle on the floor.
I tell people all the time with this, when people do that, because there's a lot of people, once they got your attention, and they're talking, and you're standing there.
Yes, we talked about that.
And they're standing there, and you're listening, and they're going, and it's like, you're like this. Mm-hmm, yeah, you're trying to be nice. You're making eye contact. You're saying, oh, honey, they think they got you now. They think, oh, she really wants to hear what I got to say. And you know what? And blah, 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 you can. And I'm like trying to figure out. I did one time this happened to me. Mm-hmm. Somebody was talking to me like that. And I kind of looked down at my watch because I really had somewhere to go. And they said, I see, you ain't paying no attention. You looking down at your watch. I said, well, wait a minute. Hold it. I said, the only reason I was looking at, I wanted to get to the store before it closed. Mm-hmm. I said, but I've heard every word you said. I've listened to you.
Twice.
And, right. So I just don't, you know, because they got
I've
offended.
I've listened to you for the last time.
Just said, quick. They got offended. But, yeah, what happens, I believe a lot of times people don't have anybody to really open up to and pour out and talk to.
So as soon
as
they...
So once you get an audience...
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you're listening, you're giving them eye contact, you're shaking your head, and it's like, more, give me more.
Yeah.
Give me more.
But to be a good friend, you have to be interested in other people.
Right.
Yes.
Not just always want to talk about your stuff.
Yes.
Well, I think I have that in here.
That's the fastest way to get rid of a friend.
Exactly.
Or a potential friend.
Exactly.
I think they talk about that in here, one of the things that they talk about, because it's not always about, you know, your situation, your problems, you know, find out what they're feeling, what they're going through, or, you know, how you, because sometimes I'll get that, they'll keep talking, oh, by the way, how you doing?
But then they don't even wait for the answer.
Right, then they keep going on. Then they
go into another conversation.
They talk for 20 minutes and give you 2 minutes, and then they keep on. Now they're not listening. They're disinterested.
They're gone.
Oh. Yeah. Or what about the person that calls you on the phone, and they don't even say, is this a good time for you?
Right, right.
They just go into it.
They just go right into it.
They start going right into their situation, and I'm like, oh my God, the you know, the pot's burning on the stove, the baby's hanging upside down, the kids are fussing and fighting.
And they're going on and on and on.
1 minute, let me just say.
Yeah. And I'm like, wait just a minute. Mm-hmm. Ask me, is this a good time? Mm-hmm. I try to do that when I'm talking to people.
Right.
Is this a good time for you?
Right, right.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Right.
Or you have a couple of minutes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's a good thing. This way it opens up the door, whether they do or they don't. They call you back, or if it's important.
Yeah, because you never know where people are, what they're doing, or.
Yeah. All right.
So.
I'll tell you. I have a little secrets on how to handle it, though. I can't give them all up. Might be one of them.
Just become her friend and you'll find out. So here's a good statement. It says, when we are with our friends, our bodies emit the feel-good hormone, oxytocin.
Oxytocin.
Not
oxycodone.
Not that. The other one.
Oxytocin.
Oh, the feel-good.
Oxytocin, mm-hmm. Helping us reduce everyday stress when we're with our friends.
Yeah.
That's good.
It's like having a good, have you ever just had like a belly laugh?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, fall out laughing.
When it was over, you
crying.
Said, I really needed that.
That's
yes.
Right.
Yes.
Laughter
really
is good medicine.
That.
It talks
yes.
about it. It's a medicine. So you get around your friends, you laugh, you talk about things, you know, that you fall out belly laughing.
Yeah.
Until you cry.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. You just can't stop. And you know how good you feel when you're done with that.
Yeah.
It
yeah.
just, it releases this, feel-good hormone, oxytocin.
Yes.
And then the other thing is, self-esteem is highly influenced by our girlfriends.
Hmm. Which mm. means it's important what kind of girlfriends you're around.
Exactly.
Because yeah. they can influence it negatively or
exactly.
positively.
So if you have someone that's constantly cutting you down,
yeah.
or constantly
yeah,
just
get,
saying
get,
little digs
that's not good.
Get rid of
to
them.
You.
Yeah. That's, you need to
you
gently distance yourself.
Distance yourself,
and
you know,
go.
Just kind of eliminate that. I think the older I get, the more I have to de-stress my life and make
sure.
things easy.
Sure.
And so there have been some friends that I've had to kind of let it go.
Mm-hmm.
Not that I'm not friendly with them, but I've had to kind of let that
well, sometimes
go.
Sometimes what happens, you start growing, and when you're growing in the things of the Lord, they're not, it's like you're kind of leaving them where they are.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so either they're going to pull you back,
or you're going to pull them.
Right. Or you suddenly realize that they really mean the things they're saying to you,
right.
even when they say, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
And that when you leave their presence, you feel
yucky.
Mm-hmm. You feel down. You don't feel lifted. You don't feel good. You feel, you know.
Cut it off. Life is too short.
Exactly. Now, we're not saying treat them ugly or be mean to them.
Right, right.
Or have an all-out brawl with them. No, there's a way to kind of let things go.
Yes.
And still be nice and still, you know.
Because one thing I find, because if they're always like negative or putting you down, if you try to correct them, a lot of times they'll get offended.
Oh.
And then you really got another issue.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
sometimes you just got to release.
And it's like you can't say anything.
Right, you can't because they're not there.
Yeah.
And they're not going to understand your feelings.
Right,
they're so stuck in their.
But girl, I was just kidding. You too sensitive. What's wrong with you?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me.
It could be secret jealousy.
Yeah, it could be a whole lot of stuff going on. Enemy could have been an assignment.
Mm-hmm.
It's designed to just wear you out, tire you out, and make you feel like you are nothing and nobody.
And so just release it. It doesn't mean that you're not a good Christian. It doesn't mean that you're not hearing from God and that you're not a woman of God.
Mm-hmm.
Just there's some things that have to be released out of our lives because they're not good for us.
Right.
Yes.
They're toxic.
They're just not good. They're toxic.
Friends.
So friendships that are causing you stress,
mm-hmm.
That are causing you anguish, that are making you think too hard, you're trying to figure out where they are and what they're
saying, all of that,
mm-hmm. just kind of let it fall to the side.
I always have a saying, if they're not bringing increase or multiplication in my life for the good, then I need to consider, you know.
Yeah.
Because if it's, you know, sowing negative things, because let's face it, if you're around a person that you consider them friends, and they're talking, eventually, if you're going, they're sowing into you.
Exactly.
This is seeds that are being sown. And next thing you know, you'll be saying what they say.
Yeah.
Say something negative.
Or if your self-esteem is affected because you're with this friend that's always doing this. This is so good to say because I think so many women are stuck in this place. There are people that they feel maybe obligated to because they've been friends with for a long time, or that's been their role in the friendship. You say whatever you want to say, you put me down, and I just smile and try to go with it because that's just the way you are. Well, that might just be the way they are, but it doesn't have to be the way you are.
That's right.
That's good.
And
that's good.
You have to cut it off because it's just not good for you.
So a friendship doesn't give a person license to treat you any kind of way.
Good. Without a doubt.
I like that.
Just because, and they may have been, you may have been good friends with them at one time.
Exactly.
Don't be afraid to grow.
Right.
Don't be afraid to move forward. You know what I mean? Because if it's time for that friendship to end, God will send someone else.
Right.
Exactly.
He ain't gonna leave you friendless nor alone.
That's right.
You know, it says trust and trustworthiness. It says it talks about when there is no trust between two people, there is no ability to give of self freely and unreservedly. Acceptance and respect. What we're talking about, see. When you accept a friend for who they are, you are not trying to change them. Jesus warns us about seeing, picking people apart, Matthew 7:3-5, seeing the speck in another person's eye and not in your own. That's that person who's always, you know, when people do that, they put others down, it's only because they're trying to lift themselves up.
Exactly.
It's really their low self-esteem.
And maybe you've put up with it because you think if I let it go, I won't have any other friends.
Right.
If I let it go, I'm going to be alone all the time.
Not true.
Well, so what? Enjoy being alone until God sends that great godly friend.
And they say something negative to me, and say something. I said, the devil is a liar. What?
Shut him right on down.
That ain't me. God said this about me. So here she goes again. But yeah, you definitely, because friendships are very important, whether they're your associates, whether you're your BFF, whether they're, you know, your comrades or, you know, constituents, whoever they may be. You want to make sure that it's going to add and multiply into your life,
edify you,
build up, encourage, and you also be the same thing to them.
Yes,
you be the light, you be the witness, you be the tool, the vessel that God has chosen to use in any relationship that we get in. That should be our whole main focus. Like earlier when we talked about maybe a needy person, they just need your love, the love of Jesus that oozes out of the very essence of your being. But you to know the difference. And then again, is there somebody toxic and then somebody's pulling you down? You may not be ready for that type of assignment.
Yes, that's right.
You got to know the
difference. If it's just wearying you.
Yeah, it is not.
Just makes you weary.
You need it because it could be an assignment. An assignment of the enemy just trying to, you know, deceive you, trick you.
Not every friendship is set by God.
Not every friendship is
It's and you have to know and discern.
You have to.
What's good for you and what you need to just cut off and let go.
Right.
Because it's not blessing you.
Because it wasn't, you know, earlier you were saying about asking God, it was you saying that God actually told you about a snake in the grass.
Yeah, snake in the grass, that the Lord spoke to me one time about someone and just said, and the person was standing there talking to me, and in my spirit I heard, there's a snake in the grass. And I knew it was God because that's not something I ever think about, snakes in the grass.
I'm glad you didn't start, was it outside and standing in some grass? Oh my God, it's a snake!
It's a snake in the grass. It's crawling up your leg. But when the Lord said that, then I knew, okay, that was the Spirit of God letting me know. When I'm around this person, I guard, guard myself, guard what I say, guard because they're a snake in the
God
grass. They're going to carry that, whatever I say, and not tell it correctly, but tell it in their own way, adding their own stuff to it. A
to
snake in the grass.
That was really good because that's no weapons formed against you. That was part of the God's divine intervention. Mm-hmm.
Now, could I worship with that person? Yes.
Sure.
Can I go into the kingdom of heaven with that person? Yes.
Can you be
Am I going to go to heaven
Lord?
With that person?
Yeah.
Yes. But they're not going to become a part.
Fellowship.
They're not going to become a part of my inner circle.
Right.
Exactly.
The inner. Or the people I allow to get close to
right.
me.
And right. Exactly.
Yeah. I had was beginning to develop a friendship with someone, but we were in two different places in our lives, and it kind of affected. They were moved around a lot, did a lot of things, mm-hmm. going a lot of places, and wanted me to be a part of that. And I could at some times, but not all the times. And that became like a problem, you know, because I may have missed some events that were important to them because of my life at the time. And I realized that, okay, I have to pull back because right now the work that is required for this relationship, I don't have to give.
Okay.
I don't
That's
have to
good.
Give.
Okay.
So, you know,
and you,
it
and
had
you
to,
recognize it, which
and,
is good.
And don't feel guilty about that.
Right.
You know, don't feel guilty if there's something that you just realize I can't do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, I just can't do it.
Friendship should never feel like a trap. They
right.
should never
exactly.
feel like a yoke. They should never feel like an obligation.
Exactly.
They should never feel like that.
Should be encouragement. A friend involves being there and asking God for wisdom to listen, empathize, and to know how to respond. Empathize. Mm-hmm. Proverbs 29:7, oil and perfume make the heart glad, so a man's counsel is sweet to his friend. Hard work and maintenance. It does take work, just like in a marriage.
It does. Just
it takes
exactly.
work. Any relationship. It
any
takes
relationship.
Work.
Your
any
relationship, relationship with your children
yes,
take work. Your
it
relationship
takes work.
With your mother takes work. Your any relationship that you have.
That's right.
That's important to you.
That's right. It takes
it's,
work.
It takes work.
It's not
going to
all be a smooth
yeah.
sailing. You gotta, you know, love unconditionally, be committed to it, trust God and give
respectful.
You the wisdom, respectful, mm-hmm. honorable, encouraging. And it says, friendship is like riding a bicycle. You either go forward or you fall down. So,
and if you know, if you're a friend and you know that your other friend, that there's something that really bothers them,
right.
don't do it.
Right.
Why would you persist
right.
in doing something
yes.
that's such a bother to the person that you call your friend
yes, yes.
and risk your friendship over that.
Right.
It's not worth it.
It's not.
That's true.
And that's not nice.
Because you keep saying something
it's not
and
nice.
They'll say, oh, you're too
it's
touchy.
Not,
instead
yeah,
of just not doing
don't
it.
Don't do it.
Right.
Don't
just don't
do it.
Do it.
Yeah, just don't do it.
I'll never forget one time James and I were counseling this couple and the wife was saying something she really didn't like the husband, what he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
So James looked at the guy and says, so well, she doesn't like it. Why do you do it?
So simple.
Yeah, it's very simple. Just
what
like what y'all
is
just
what
don't
is
do
that?
It. Why would you do? She doesn't like that. Well, why would you
exactly.
do that?
Why would you keep doing that?
Right.
What is that?
Yeah.
It's not God.
No.
It's not God.
No, it's not.
That puzzles me. when I'm in counseling and I hear the person say and they just keep doing it, I'm like, well, why would you do that?
Right.
If it
like
bothers
it.
Her, she doesn't like it.
Right.
Stop it.
Right.
Don't do it.
No, don't do it. Don't be so bullheaded that you have to
well,
do this thing.
Well, she shouldn't be so whatever. Or, you know, they always people have put it on the other person.
Exactly.
Why they shouldn't be like that. Why
yeah.
they shouldn't, you know, why you got to be so sensitive? Why you got to always be offended? You
oh,
need
I've
to
hurt
get
your
over
feelings
that.
Now. But
you
go
need to
home
get
and
over
cry.
That. You need
yeah.
to stop that. No, you
so
need to stop.
So it's something in that person
that's right.
that they want to torment the other person with because
right.
they're being tormented.
Exactly.
Right.
Because if you love someone, you don't want
to
do something
right, to hurt
that you
them.
Know is bothering
exactly.
them.
Exactly.
Keep doing. If I keep doing this,
yeah. and it hurts you,
and I hate that.
Right. And I keep doing it. I'm trying to get on your nerves.
Exactly.
Now. You know that's
yeah.
terrible.
Because you're not
and
honoring
it's
her,
not,
respecting
and you're not
her.
Just kidding.
Right.
You really are.
And that means they're
annoying.
Poking at you, and they know they're poking you.
Right.
They know that you're being annoyed, and they like the fact that you're annoyed.
Right.
Exactly.
And I want to say, toughen up.
Secretly, they want to get to
toughen
you.
Toughen up, Judy. Toughen up.
There's certain areas they don't like.
And I
want to
say, shut up.
She would never tell me to shut up.
I would never. I don't even like the word shut up. I don't. I won't let the kids in the house say shut up. I'll say, don't say shut up. Just shut up.
Shut up out there.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, you know what? I think you should pray.
Yes.
For people watching, listening, that want better friendships. Or
yeah.
To all my
be
BBF friends out there.
BFF.
BFF.
All three of you?
All two, three of y'all. God bless you. Bless you.
Okay, so we're going to pray for people that desire good friendships, yes. that God brings those people into your life. And then I want to pray for people that throughout this show that you've discovered that some of the friendships you have, you can release it mm-hmm. happily. And let it go because it's not edifying you. Mm-hmm. And the things that you struggle with about that friendship, the times that you felt so guilty, the times that you don't want to answer the calls, it's you know, but you do it anyway because you think I've been their friend for years. Just release it and let it go in love, gracefully, and know mm-hmm. that God will supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ mm-hmm. Jesus. He knows the kind of friends that you need in yes. your life, and he will supply what is needed for you.
Yes.
So, yeah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I just pray, Lord God, for all of the women that are watching this show that really desire friends. They desire that friend that's going to share their confidences, that friend that's going to lift them, bless them, encourage them, be there for them, that's not going to put them down or mistreat them. Thank we pray right now, Holy
you,
Spirit,
God.
That
yes.
you open their eyes to
yes.
see
yes.
the friends that you are placing,
yes.
planting into their life to bless them.
Mm-hmm.
And Lord, then we pray for those that are in a situation where they have friendships that they need to just let go of
yes.
because it's wearying them, it's bringing them down, it's making them feel less of a person, less of who they are, it's affecting their self-esteem. Father, we just pray right now that they have the courage by the Holy Spirit and the grace to discern and know, I can let it go
mm-hmm.
and I don't have to feel guilty.
Yes.
I can move on because God has so much more for
yes.
me than
yes.
this.
Yes.
And we thank you for it, Father,
yes.
in Jesus' name.
And one last comment that I wanted to make. The Holy Spirit
okay.
will back up my spirit again. In the body of Christ, even though you may not call them your friends, but we're all sisters
mm-hmm.
in the Lord.
Yes.
We're all
yes.
sisters. No matter where you are in your walk, where you are in your talk, if you're in the kingdom, we are sisters.
Yes.
Don't forget that.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly.
And the Lord brought that back in my spirit. He did before, and I, you know, mm-hmm. I let it go, and he brought it back.
Yeah,
up.
I like
Make that.
Make that yeah.
distinction.
Mm-hmm.
We are all sisters.
Because
we
talked a lot about that BFF, or that real close friend,
right,
but
right.
understanding that in the body of Christ, there are so many mm-hmm. that,
right.
that we're sisters.
We're mm-hmm. sisters in the Lord.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What is that song that...
I need you.
I need you.
You need
mm-hmm.
me. And we do need each other, and it's God that's going to connect you, put you with the right people
yes.
to receive what you need to have at the mm-hmm. season and the time that you need to have it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's us being sisters. So they
yes.
may not be your best friend, may not even be your friends,
mm-hmm.
but they are your sisters.
That's
mm-hmm.
right.
And you
yeah.
want to love them with the love of God.
And we
that's
don't
good.
Harm each other by the words of our mouth
yes.
because we're sisters.
Amen.
Yes.
And families stick together.
Amen.
We are joined by the blood of Jesus, the name of Jesus. We are all a part of God's family.
Amen.
And that's good.
That's
sisterhood.
Good.
Really good.
Sisterhood.
Yeah,
that's good. It also helps for those someone who say, "Well, I don't have a best friend," but you can recognize in your sisters.
Yes.
Who has what you need
that's
at
right.
the time?
Exactly.
Because there's so many.
That's right.
So that you may be one that you can laugh with. Maybe one you can cry with.
Yeah.
Maybe one that loves to sample foods or
right.
you know, one you can
exactly.
have a Bible study
right.
with.
Exactly.
So learn to recognize who's
right.
there for whatever
recognize
the time.
Recognize the blessing
yes.
and
yes.
the
yes.
gift
mm-hmm.
that God is putting in your midst
yes.
for what you may need and for what you have to give.
Yes.
Because we as women, we need you. Sisters
yep.
in the Lord.
Yes,
yes we do.
So to all of our sisters out there, we want to tell you that you are graced
for everything
that you face.
God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you for watching Straight Talk for Women Only.
See you next month.
Amen.